5-1-1 in their last seven games. The Bruins lead the overall standings in the NHL. The game is on.
He made both plays have to avoid contact by stepping around 7 and white.
You can't teach compete level. Stutzla, who is on a heater.
So Jake DeBrusk.
Not high sticking. Bernard Docker paired with McAvoy. The Bruins in the middle of a change. Jacob Blauko picks up his glove and Frederick is robbed by Corpusolo.
Here in the first 3 minutes of the hockey game, 3 minutes or less. Go back to that play through the neutral zone. Grizzlick looking for Lauko. Lauko does a nice job coming off that left wing, fills the middle, and even though it's not a clean play through center ice, punch it down the wall, and then Geeky.
Centers and Parker Kelly couldn't make the play. Kastelic to Kachuk. Kastelic, the slot. Pasternak picks the puck up. Centers, Shabbat, failed clear. Grizzlick scores off a skate of Pasternak.
To allow this pass to be completed, Pasternak's going to cruise into the high slot. Stick on stick right there against Giroux. And that allows that puck to get back to the left point. And then the little wrist shot, he's going to deftly tip it with the blade of his stick up over the glove of Corpusolo.
On Bernard Docker. Stutzla. Pasternak has a breakaway! And he scores! He now has 43.
Stutzla's a good player, but this is just a bad pass. Maybe he felt the heat coming down from the blue line. The body contact was coming his direction. He tried to force a play in the middle. And Pasternak, who got all the way in on the forecheck, Jack, he called it. He went for the big solid hit below the goal line, but kind of slowed the play down and then made a nice block.
Eric Brännström on a solo rush, kicked to the corner by Ullmark. From his knees, Bernard Docker off a leg. Danton Heinen on the counter, Pasternak to Lindholm, and a save by Corpusolo. Behind Ullmark, Marchand square to Lindholm. Coyle sends it right through the crease. $500,000 donated to the SCORE program. Explain that.
Well, SCORE Boston was the first grant ever given out.
Swivels, Sanderson, the keep-in, Batherson to the corner. Kachuk, Sanderson off the bar, and he sprinted off his line. Stutzla to Chychrun. Chychrun, a tipped one-timer by Kachuk. Let's go Bruins, the champ from the 17,850, and an impossible angle shot
by Ullmark. Matheson, who can really shoot it, quick release.
Yeah, unbelievable. That was a huge kill there, by the way, but that was amazing. It's the 100th anniversary has been just incredible to be a part of. I'll look forward to the post game as well. But I just have to give a shout out to everybody at Nesson. The show that aired last night was first class. They really did a great representation of all the work the foundation has done over the years.
Shabbat shoots and Ullmark makes the stop. Drew closes. Pinto gets it through Ullmark. It's 2-1.
That's a well-executed play. A lot of moving parts to set up that play to Pinto in the slot. And when you watch Pinto, where he starts and where he ends up to get open, he starts down close to that low hash, and the minute Giroux starts to move lower and lower, Pinto's able to rotate out, create an easy passing lane. It's a one-timer because it's a right-handed shot. This is real good execution. There's your two-on-one out high, the fake shots. You kind of get committed to what Giroux's doing because that puck's off his right hip. And
DeBrusk gains the line. Shattenkirk shoots, and Brazeau, the big boy, in a big spot, puts Boston ahead 3-1. Geeky's skate was not over the blue line.
This is your second power play unit, simple in nature. Shattenkirk at the top of the umbrella, the drag snap through traffic. Brazeau with a little redirect, gets his own rebound, shows a lot of poise. That's a good one-timer. No takeaway at all.
Batherson saved by Olmarkin. They score with 2.3 seconds left in the period. Brady Tkachuk makes it a one-goal game again.
I mean, time running out in the period. You get a big power play goal. You got bodies back, but nobody's eliminating bodies. Nobody's eliminating the stick of Tkachuk. The puck's in and out of the glove of Olmark. You'd like to see him squeeze that one off. And the relentlessness of the Ottawa captain.
Yep.
And I'd like to see Boston play with the puck a little bit more here in the third period. I mentioned that in the first, and then in the second when I was looking at the score and the time on the clock and how one-sided it was in favor of Ottawa. I needed those last 5 minutes to be meaningful. And then they get the power play goal. I was surprised it wasn't challenged for an offside.
I think it pinged the post. Shattenkirk to Pasternak, centers right through the crease. Pasternak scores! Hat trick!
And then Pasternak's able to chase this puck down behind the net, makes a pass through the crease. Shattenkirk tries to find Pavel Zacha from a backhand.
Pretty good help. Pasternak would get the 100-point milestone tonight. He's 1 point away. Jesper Boqvist scores! Between goal.
Clean breakout. Peter playing the wing in this situation. On that breakout, he gets open, and as soon as he gets it, he gets his feet moving. And Boqvist is off to the races up that offside. It's a great breakout. Everybody in motion, filling those three lanes. And when you have speed through center ice, it's difficult to contain. And Boqvist has got a lot of speed.
Ridley Gregg, checked by Shattenkirk. DeBrusk makes the defensive play, gets it to Brazeau, and Morgan Geeky had the puck bounce on him. Shattenkirk to DeBrusk. Jake Sanderson up, not out. Geeky gets it to Brazeau. Brazeau scores his second goal of the night.
We saw Brazeau try this at even strength. We showed a replay of it back earlier in the hockey game when he took a feed from Grizzlick, and he tried that move, and he couldn't elevate the shot because he couldn't finish because of the stick check. But with the man advantage here, you can see he's already in motion.
Boqvist runs out the clock. The Bruins decisively 6-2.